like that.
Exactly.
You're more aware, you're slower when you don't use the wall, because you're more controlled, because you don't, I mean, even though you know the wall is there, you don't just jerk or kick off. You do it slower. You may try without the wall.
Yeah.
You try without the wall. Come away from the wall. And see if you can just push your arms enough. I mean, you're not touching the wall anyway. So, yeah. There. Now just control. Just control. Don't go too far. Don't go too fast. Exactly. There you go. There. See? You don't need the wall. Practicing legs straight and close to each other and bringing down, what is harder? Mm-hmm. Legs split apart or legs straighter? To bring legs together.
Straighter is harder?
Some dolphin and loosen the shoulders. Did it make a difference? Do you find one easier than the other? Head straight or
just
split?
Different?
No?
Different.
I think like straight. Like this is easier.
Easier?
Split.
Oh.
But maybe it's because I can't split very well.
Yeah, it's easier type for you. So.
Yeah.
I was able to balance more in the split.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
I don't feel very comfortable splitting. I'm not that flexible there.
They're just really different.
Yeah, the knees do bend for you, Margaret. Well, I think, you know, once your arm engages to a certain extent and your back is firm, then, I mean, like, I could really feel it.
Both are the same, actually.
Yeah, so I think, once your back strength increases to a certain level, then you probably
and
won't
also,
you
just
to
put
the
weight on the arms,
right,
so
yeah.
It is like both are the same.
Right.
Yeah.
But it just feels different. Like, you can just different feeling.
Yeah. Yeah, like Mark said, you know, if the hamstrings are tight, then the split might be a bit harder because you're stretching.
That makes sense.
When you go forward, you want to keep your head as high as you can. That allows you to extend the shoulders, which is useful for dancing peacocks, scorpion, bridges with elbows on the floor, everything, right? From forward bends to back. Bring your elbows a little bit closer to mine. Hank, bring your elbows a little bit closer. Okay, try and challenge yourself. Keep your head up and walk forward. Walk forward. Find out at what point your head pushes into the floor. Yeah, keep going, yeah, keep going. Lift head up, look head up. Arch your back, arch your back. Yeah. Yeah. At what point? Keep walking.
But legs are not going to be straight.
Straight is easy, half is hard. Yeah, right there, we're right there. So bend one knee straight down the line. That's not much. It's okay, the head is on the floor, just try 90 degrees, like, pause there.
Is that right?
Right from the hips and go forward, that way, yeah, that way, this way, and hold it, that way, that way. Right from the hips, lower, yeah, that way. Yeah, right there, yeah, hold,
walk right there.
Yeah, right from the hips, hold, and lower, lower feet slowly, you have to engage your back and stomach. Your elbows anchor, your head anchors. Yeah, right there. Pause.
That's really good, Mark.
Pause. No, push, keep pushing elbows down. Keep pushing elbows down. Right now it's your head and back. That arch. Lower. Right there. Pause at the point where you feel you can lift weight, where you can hold.
Yeah.
Your arms get tired. This is cool. I think you're right. Yeah. Get on the toes, big toes. Get tall. Stretch the back, stretch the tailbone as high as you can. Extend the shoulders, push elbows down. Right there. Come a little bit more. Yeah, right there. Yeah.
Not forward,
that.
Bend.
Did you say?
Yeah, keep legs strong. Lock. Man. There you go. This is easier for you, right?
Okay.
Yeah, the hamstrings are not bothering as much. Very good. I would have thought straight leg close would be harder, but for you seems. Hamstrings.
I don't know why that is.
Well, the hamstrings. Now, sitting, split legs is actually easier than legs together. Western is harder. In Western, we keep legs together, that's harder because the hamstring split is easier.
Okay.
But I don't know, you're upside down, why split is easier?
Right.
So, right, we are putting weight at, from different angles, right, different alignment. You lay down on your back, you stand on your feet, you lay on your, sit on your legs. You're putting the weight, you know, it's the same shape, you're rotating clockwise but counterclockwise. Let's try this. Let's, I guess it could see your picture. Right, so with heel down, let's go to the back, go to the wall. Let your back rest against the wall, and then see if everybody can put their shoulders and arms against the wall or not. So keep feet on the ground.
Sitting or standing?
Or?
Sitting.
Keep on the ground, come forward. Yeah, right. So we are all going to do that, right?
Kind of. It's hard for me.
Oh, well, with the heels on the ground?
Yeah. Put two blocks, hang
on. Yeah,
yeah.
Forward, Mark.
Yeah.
Some more. Move forward more. Oh, they're fine.
Like that.
Yeah.
There you go.
How much weight the wall is taking, right? So now we think we can keep this distance between ribs and thighs when we come off the wall. So toes are lifted, so now come forward, away from the wall. Let's see if you can lean back enough with the toes lift. And what are you going to lose? How big is the fall going to be?
Oh, you're
right
saying,
there.
You're
yeah.
saying move forward,
come forward
off.
Yeah, come forward.
Oh,
keep thighs away from the wall. Yeah.
Toes lift up.
That's right. That's what you want. You want toes to lift. You want weight of the heels.
Right.
Back. Yeah, shift back.
I can change my I'm gonna help the wall. I'll go out here and if I fall, I'm gonna totally put toward the down with the wall.
But see how, what is the point? At what point do you fall? Find out. At what point your back cannot hold you anymore?
That point. That point.
Come forward, please. Come forward.
Am I straight?
I can care with my arms.
Ah, oh, there you go.
Just
but unless you can see that, can you show me where that is? Hold on a second, that takes me a second. So you cannot go straight, is that what it is, or are you eventually
good? Eventually, I think it's a little bit of the ankles, back
stretch.
So this is how much weight the wall was taking?
Yeah.
Oh. You know, someone else told me.
Okay.
I wish we.
That's too long.
Yeah.
It's always
and
a
lot of sectors. You have to balance.
Yes.
I wish we did that. I mean,
they are beautiful.
Thanks a lot. Spread
leg. Yeah, now squeeze leg.
For a reason. Like, since we had six.
Yeah, no, I know.
We're shooting for 5 minutes, maybe 5 minutes, and just balancing.
Right. Right.
Yeah. Here, we are just sitting and reading these bits.
That's why I'm saying I wish we did it that way, just because it would be more flexible. It would be harder, but it would be...
It's like me? Hey, crane and side crane, this is some way. It's a warm up chicken. You did the warm up in chicken, crane and side crane.
Beating the speech was amazing.
Yes,
really, he gave really good speech.
Oh,
the captain.
Oh, did he? Yeah,
yeah,
I missed that.
It was amazing. Yeah, I listened to parts of it, I did.
He's kind of talking about
he does
really
so
was that a girl?
Yeah. No, I mean,
I met a girl that...
He looks very, very bold. Yeah, he is what, 70 plus.
Is
it?
We're gonna look really young.
Because
now.
Chelsea
we're
is
gonna
like
look so
36, 37.
So what makes it challenging
and
is
he had a problem,
and
so
he
just
yes.
Bypassed
yeah.
it.
Right, he
yes.
did, yeah.
Crane, side crane.
Crane.
So first, warm up in crane. Don't stay too long. I think all of you have tried their seeing somebody try side crane, so a lot of you like that. Yeah, there. So you want elbows straight, we want shoulders. Stretch fully, so you are using more and more bulk in the beginning, but then you'll go to reduce the bulk, right? So right now you're using more oblate in each. Be sure you're compact, lift knees up and side crane. Even in crane, you get the shins of the, yeah, so first twist, just twist, get on the toes, big toes, lift your hips as high as you can. So yeah, like cow milking, go the ikasan, yeah, sit on the toes, and then just lower on one side, yeah. And lower your head, yeah, keep knees up into the armpits, knees up, the knee that is locking against the elbow, get to the armpit, yeah, just twist, put your head down and straighten the legs, head down, pushing elbow under the leg, push the right elbow under the knee, left elbow against the waist, and drop your head really in front of the hands, yeah, like that, pull legs up, get on the toes and big toes, the higher you are, the easier it is. Yeah, get the toes because we are. That's good. Yes, head between head in between hands. Yeah, keep legs firm. Keep legs pushing against the elbow. Keep pushing against the elbow. Right. That's it. Very good.
So hard to keep.
Just a twist. First, just twist. If you take a couple of breaths and give your body time to twist, it'll be a lot easier. So you can lift knees up as well as you can push elbows down, right? You can lift knee up. Right? So So this is down. With knees up. Get on toes, get on big toes. The higher you are, the easier it is because the knee locks against the armpit much better, right? Now I have a lot more surface area, a lot more contact points. And yeah, twist that way, right, exactly. The more you twist that way, the better. Yeah, right there, see? The knees are in the armpits, yeah, yeah. And aim for your head somewhere here. What is that knee sliding out?
Well, it's are you going too far out?
My feet feel like they're stuck.
So it hurts to,
yeah,
pop out.
Like feet, you, okay, so let's take off.
Feet were,
just like up.
Your feet were higher than mine.
No, so I think it's the stomach that needs to somehow, or you know, the middle body somehow needs to hold the legs.
Yeah.
A bit, not let them slide out.
Am I? But there's still a lot of weight on my foot.
Yeah.
So it's hard to
but you,
get
you,
this.
Right, so how will you just weight on the hands? If you keep your hands a little bit further out, maybe? Yeah, so let's do that. So here, let's start a little bit further out and then lean, so the weight is all on the hands. That makes it easy. Because there is no weight on the feet. Yeah, start further out and then lean on your hands. Do the down dog. Yeah, there.
Yeah, okay.
If
we can find what's blocking the pose, we can unlock. Twist, sideways. Look at me up, towards me up.
Both hands this way. So knees face front.
Hands
face the sideways. And actually, yeah, I mean, you know, this is probably better to be as high and as far out as possible. Maybe you don't need to start with the chicken here. Right? Do this and just lean into it. There you go. Well, you're right, Mark. You don't need to shift weight on the hands. So start a little bit higher.
Okay, feet this way. Hands
easy,
this way.
Relax. Liz, look inside. Look down. Don't need to look outside. Straighten the neck like that. Yeah, bring, lock this.
Yes, it's
really, the twist is the difficult this
way. That's going to take a little.
Keep you at a legs in the curve.
There you go, honey. That's good.
Yeah.
Very good. Lift your legs up.
Easy.
No.
You're a lot farther along than I am. Look where the hands are.
Yeah,
with the
blocks.
Don't
offend,
just keep twisting.
Yeah.
Yeah. Too much weight on
it. Lift your stomach.
It's
fine.
It's fine. Your knee and waist should lock. Your knee and waist should lock, and then go from this. Yeah. No, but you're too close. No, I gotta keep it. Right.
Okay.
The weight on the arm. Other side.
Okay.
Lock your left knee against the right knee against the
that
left.
One should sit on the.
Both feet.
And I have to go front.
Yeah, and then this one sits here, right there.
That's it. We just need to balance. Hey, let's flex arms. Let's do the eagle of the stomach. We have to confuse ourselves. Lay down on the stomach and then wrap your legs.
Like the twist.
Like that, yeah. Yeah, they don't get this. So you can go on your side and then get an eagle and then it'll come down into stomach.
Oh my gosh, my knees not liking that very much.
No. The problem in the solution.
Cross knees first, when I wear my sweatpants, I'm doing much better.
Okay, so
both knees. Which knee you're not bending?
Yeah.
Which knee you're not bending? Think which knee you're not bending.
My legs are.
Yeah, like that. Yeah, yeah.
Like this.
That's the problem.
Okay.
Where are they?
Okay, warm up, lay down on your stomach, and back and right.
Is this okay?
Yeah,
I can't do
the other
side.
Am I
close to the others? Can you help me?
Yeah, you're
welcome. But did you still get my
I don't hear you, girl.
Oh my goodness.
I don't hear you.
Turn your back. Turn your back.
Oh, my neck.
I'm laying on my back. Oh, yeah. Was that just you? I think you're just like. Oh, no.
Yep, that's good. So try which side is easier for you. Mark on your back. Lay on your back. Try which side is easier and then try that side. I don't know. You can just roll on your stomach from your back.
Well, if I go like this.
Yeah, no, can you just roll on your stomach? Keep it locked.
Like that.
Right? And then turn it off? Yeah.
Yeah, but where am I?
Yeah, keep going.
Yay!
Yeah, roll your legs.
Yeah, but.
That's
okay.
Like this one.
It certainly doesn't feel right. I can't look right.
No, but so what I'm trying to understand is why can't you do it on your stomach? Okay, let's because so unlock. Wait, let me try. Unlock.
I won't push
it. Okay, now try this leg up.
This one?
Yeah, this leg up.
That's about it.
One of the challenges is to not straighten the leg, we fight.
Oh, I see.
We just fight, and you know, there's this instinct of, you know, by hook or crook, just getting into the pose, and our body instinct just forces and straightens the knee out.
I think
when I wear sweat,
the straight way is when it is straight, it doesn't go, just bend and then do it.
There you see, that's what you can do.
Just like that. Just like that.
Okay, you can do that again. So,
now, all you have to do is just roll over towards the earth. Yeah, roll. Let's see, Hank can do it, then everybody should go.
Hold it this way.
What does that tell you? The same thing that you did. She lay down on just the back and did it, and then rolled over. So what does it teach us? That teaches us that the challenge is not the pose, but how to get into the pose.
That's right.
So all we are trying to do is find the steps. Get into the pose.
It's easy for you to say.
No, but that was
easy. I understand.
You did all over?
Yes.
It's much easier. It works very well. Okay, let's work the stomach up a little bit.
Let's do full boat, half boat, and then we'll do the movement. Let's do the staying and then we'll come to the movement. So we'll do the let's do the half boat first because our stomachs are in our necks. So in half boat, you want to spread out as much as you can. Sit on your sit and stuff. Come a little bit away forward. And then lean back, lean back, where you feel there is not as much weight on the legs, right? To that point, and then the legs will lift. No, yeah, there. So this is easiest, keeping knees bent, holding your legs. Legs straight is hard. Hardest. Lose some weight on your stomach. This is your chance. Stay. Broaden the elbows. Don't be high. Yeah.
Why do you sit? You mean because you're building a muscle?
Yeah.
I do that 40 seconds.
Yeah. 40 seconds. Right. Okay. So touch your stomach when you're in the pose, Mark. Not a single point
it's
is
like
going to be loose. There's nothing. Nothing. No.
Yes.
This whole area,
looks like
nothing is rock. Literally. I mean, you know, this is Bruce Lee. You could hold that, there's no fat. So that was all our 10, 12 second mark, so you can follow mine in 40 seconds.
Okay.
There you go, Hank is enjoying. He's thinking of the delicious dinner he's made tonight. Right? Just take your mind off, and body is fine. No complaints. Right? Yeah, it's a full boat. So full boat is opposite. So half boat works on the stomach, full boat works on the back. Right? This we want for half boat. We want this. Full boat. We want this. Half boat. We did this. Full boat, you want to lift the tailbone up. So you tilt back, but keep pushing the ribs, chest forward. This arch. So your tailbone does not touch the floor, only the sit bones. So initially, you find a balancing point, and then it should really easy. I like to lock my thumb, so my left side of the body connects with the right side. Otherwise, they are two separate things, right? Left and right, they go on their own. Once they're connected. As soon as you find balance with knees bent, then close your eyes. Arch more, rounding this. Arch, no other way. Yeah, arch. So pull your toes, push your toes. Pull with fingers, push with toes. And that stretches your legs, your arms, your back. Everything is stretched out. Close your eyes. This is one of the coolest pose, balancing pose. Almost everybody can balance with eyes closed.
Money up. Maybe take the belt, money.
Then I lose balance.
Yeah, well, this pose is a little bit harder with belt, but so here, maybe
you
don't hold the toes.
Leg, actually,
hold the knees. Hold the knees, yeah. It's a little bit harder as
you
well.
You can straighten the knees also. Shorten the distance. Hold it closer to them.
Okay, let's say that. This is the leg lifts. So if you are comfortable, if you need to do this one, then do this one. Your palms push round, just like half board. Push your back into your palms. Your palms are under your lower back. You can keep legs straight while going up and down. Otherwise, bend while lifting, straighten while lowering. Keep elbows really close and back. Close to you and farther back. Okay, so Vila, Liz, Raji, try 5 or 7 of these and then do the side stretches for side leg lifts. Lay down on your back. Arms to the side, and then legs come close to the palms. Every few repetition, lower the legs, relax, and so on. So, okay, let's go try inside. Yeah, go all the way, relax, take a little breath, take a little breath, take a little breath, please. build there. That's when the muscles cramp. Use your arms really strong and feet come close to the palms. Do you feel like flexing the knee, or you think this is, I mean, the kneecaps are pulled up, so I guess the legs are straight.
Oh, are you saying they look crooked?
Yeah. Well, no, so there, okay, so maintain that, now lift. Okay, how high can you go? Yeah, then, okay, and go down and pull kneecaps up. Yeah, now lift. Yeah, right, so at that point it seems
yeah.
The pull kind of goes away a little bit and then it deflects a little bit. So that I think is the hip joint and the hamstring that you were saying earlier. Maybe that's what's
okay.
showing up in the so hamstring stretches. Every day, you know, the side hamstring stretch, Vera is really good at that. So every day, if you can, and that you can repeat every day. You can repeat.
Every day, okay.
Yeah, I mean, you know, just try 2 weeks, you'll be amazed how quickly this up and going.
Okay.
So, I mean, like, you already know the history. You had the hip joint from childhood, right?
So
maybe that somehow adds to that tightness. But if you can,
but it is possible to improve it, right?
Yeah, if there is something that if you can stretch the hamstring, who knows, maybe that would be helpful. Because hamstring, if you don't stretch hamstring, by default they're tight.
Okay. Yeah.
Everything we do, you know, the way we sit, the way we walk, if you ride bike, everything we do, there's nothing but shorten the hamstring and make them tight and contract.
Yeah.
So you have to intentionally stretch them.
And that's an everyday thing.
I think you should do, must do every day. Right? Take a couple bites of few breaths and then upper body lifts. Put Adi out of business, man. He's going to be disappointed when he comes back.
Oh, don't worry, he's got the job.
He doesn't need my help anymore.
They're not the kind.
Yeah, next Wednesday.
Oh, wow.
Yay.
How long have they been gone?
2 months.
Wow. He's gonna grow.
I know.
Run under.
Oh, yeah.
And then
these days
talking in Hindi, so it will take them a while to switch back to English, right?
Okay.
Because they're all the cousins.
Oh. That'll be interesting. Yeah. Yeah, we'll have to go to the track again.
Yeah.
Are they having a good time?
Yeah. So Adi keeps asking me to go there, to come there. And I explain to him, no, but I have work. He says, what work do you have? Work in the cornfield. He says, okay, so do your work and then come here. But it's really far. You know, okay, so come in the plane. But I come there in the plane, by the time I reach there, it's time for me to do the work here again.
That's great.
I don't know how to explain the concept of time. Stomach, the line drills that you used to say. Practice as if you're doing handstand laying down on the stomach, and then we'll do the handstands.
You'll explain that?
Yep, so lay down on the stomach.
Or take a breath first.
Yep, take it.
wondering the same thing.
Don't chase out the legs.
Try stand with an ascent to stop it.
Is your old,
is that your oldest?
Right, okay. You see,
Yeah, keep your arms this way, keep head this way.
Let's do.
And I think what he said is stretch your arms out. And without arching the back, lift your arms up.
Face.
And leg. Yeah, yeah. So arms behind.
Without the arching your back.
Yeah, without arms up. This.
Oh.
Anyway, at some point, you'll feel that that's. The shoulders kind of locked, they won't like that. Yeah.
So what he wants, what he was suggesting is to find that line. We want to be in a straight line. See, arch is very easy, you know, dancing peacock is very easy, headstand is easy because there's mild arch and people can do that. But it's the handstand without support that gets really challenging because you really need to be
without
straight.
The wall?
Without
and you say without support.
Right, right. So if you wanted to do it without the wall, you would have to take that arch out. And actually, trust me, it is a lot easier to be straight than arch. Arch, you can't stay for too long. Yeah, so if you lower your head a little bit early. And lock stiffer. Tighten yourself, the whole body, from fingertips to toes. And then you can't lift your arms too high. Yeah, money, that's good. That's good. More. Yeah, try.
Stomach.
So don't be relaxed. Try and, you know, really firm up all the way from arms. So then, yeah, I don't think you can lift your shoulders too high.
That's alright.
Yeah, but no, I think that means you are doing you're doing a firming up.
Right. It's only a bit longer.
Were you here for him? Did you see him? I think it was the Sunday, the guy who came.
To push your
yeah, just stretching the wrist in different ways.
Oh, yeah.
I have to look up the video again, I think.
Right.
So, you know, in order to do the handstand without the wall, you have to engage. So think of your foot. Think of our foot, right? If you want to go forward, you push this, if you were leaning back, so both, there are two points, right? Down and up, down and up, back and front. So you similarly need two points here to balance yourself. If you're leaning this way, then this needs to push and pull you back. If you're leaning this way, then this pushes and pulls you forward, pushes you forward, right? So this kind of works as the foot, right? It can't be one point. It has to be two points, right? So he was saying, when we do it with the wall, I think we use our wrists too much. We don't engage fingertips, and that is not uncommon. You know, you do down dog, and it's very easy to just ignore this.
Mm-hmm.
You do the scorpion, dancing peacock, handstand, you know, you can easily ignore this, right? But this is really powerful in order for you to balance.
Mm-hmm.
So when you're doing handstand without the wall, if you want to do handstand without the wall, you need fingertips, right? Crank. You can't do this on this, you can't balance. So in order to, for people to engage and learn engaging fingertips, he said do this.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, these are the bad. What do you mean by part?
Yeah.
I'm doing it correct, right? Yeah.
Yeah. So basically, just lifting the wrist. Lift wrist. Lift wrist. Wrists.
Yeah. Understand.
Yeah. No. Don't move.
Leave your fingers there.
Leave your fingers there. Just breathe up.
Yeah.
Come
up there.
Well, you're still. It's okay. You're just doing it.
Yeah.
You'll get better at it.
I hear a lot of cracking.
I can feel it in my elbow.
Yeah.
One of my elbow joint bothers me a little bit, so I can feel it in here. I don't feel it as much in this, but this, I can feel that.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Mm-hmm.
Now it must be.
Okay.
Let's try
the handstand now.
I think that's the reason why I'm so cautious about the handstand, because I'm not confident in my hands support me.
Body strength is really good. I mean, you're playing and down dog, all these points.
But it seems like when you're holding my leg, I feel like a little more confidence than just my hands alone.
Not basically.
I don't know. Ready?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Come here, Mark.
Here?
I'm going to wait for him. I'm going to wall.
Then what did he say? To straighten yourself, pull stomach in, maybe walk towards the wall.
No, not me.
You look very good on your wrist there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, the fingertips are fine.
For me to warm up a little, come back.
Oh, yeah, right there.
Look down. Warm up. Little back.
Pull. Push hands down and lift elbows up, waist up, get stretched. Stretch your arms. Yeah, get tall. Yeah, now one more. Be light. So one can feel by the amount of weight you put on it.
Wow.
So then I think you were saying that you engage your
We're gonna put that on a t-shirt.
Yeah, hold it tight.
Hold it tight.
So you gotta pull the whole body forward. Tighten. Yep.
Without
the wall.
Basically
tighten the whole body.
Keep your hands as close as you can.
I know it's a little bit more challenging, but it will allow you to get your shoulders under your chest.
I just don't feel confident.
The biggest thing is to whip your head out. Like when
tighten up. Think of that line drill. A line. Lock your shoulders.
Think about the worst thing that could happen is you're like someone in the wall. I just feel like my arms are gonna hold me or something. I don't know.
But they're not gonna just grab
your arms. Yeah, I think.
Good reader. I think
your arms.
Straighten them up. Straighten them up. Straighten them up.
Motion.
Use your back. Use your arms and see if you can take your feet off the wall. Roll your. Yeah. Yes.
Okay.
Very good. Very good. There was light. There was light.
I don't know how to go up, but I can hover it. Well, you know how.
Walk.
It just doesn't feel right. But now I'm going lighter. Yeah, you know, but you just don't know. You don't. Yeah.
That is, you don't have confidence.
Keep arms close to each other. Shoulders and chest. Keep closer, arms closer.
Someday.
That's what I say. Keep
closer,
arms closer.
And pushing the fingertips down, it firms up, it sends the energy, electricity throughout the body, and pulls.
Make yourself as long.
Your feet long, as long.
I wish one of those.
Look this. This is loose, this is stuck. Okay, stretch, tight, and squeeze. The feet see automatically come off. Okay, just, so this is relaxed, this is where you need to walk. This. This. Toes, fingertips, stomach. Yeah. Yeah. The wall isn't needed because you are taking. I think when you firm up, we take the arch out. If you're not arched, you're not going to lean into the wall because you're. Few inches away from your hands are few inches away from the wall. So when you relax, there's an arch. And that's how the feet go into the wall. Because hands are not next to the wall. Hands are all the way here. So if you are straight, the feet won't go in the wall. When you're relaxed, there's an arch. But when you firm up,
that makes sense.
The feet just go off the wall. Right? So it's this part. It's the hands that firm up and send energy through the ribs, through the back. Money was doing what Liz did earlier, walking towards the wall. That's very helpful as well. How close can you go? You should be able to try that.
Should go this way.
I don't.
Extending the shoulders, keep extending the shoulders. Yeah, extending the shoulders. Get tall and tall and push the leg down. Yep.
Last time. I did this again.
I'm gonna be a lot worse. Oh, Hank is still here. Oh, no. I'm
trying to get closer.
Yeah,
confidence in that.
Do that.
say you pink much better than I do.
Yeah, slowly come on, Hank, slowly.
I know, I'm in trouble.
I'm stuck.
I'm stuck again.
Okay.
Water. Thank you.
Yeah, I'm stuck.
Well, if you lose 5 pounds, I only can hold you in 1 hour, right?
No. Oh, see what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah, I do something on the hips, the kayaking, canoeing. Grinding mill,
grinding.
What's it?
Grinding.
Oh, I haven't used this.
That's canoeing.
Keep hands
away.
Oh,
like the
grind. Okay.
Yeah.
Don't intentionally let it lift. Let the feet lift. Don't do it. Away from the legs, onto the hands. Away from the legs, forward. You might be afraid, right? What happens?
I just sit here.
Yeah, so back.
I got too far for that. Okay, I think that's what I can do.
More room than less, right? Now you have a lot of room. So why don't you more room? It's the fingertips, right? It's the fingertips that I want to engage in. Fingertips that engage once I've tilted it up. Western peacock? Yeah. Knees push down and then knees lift up. His knees flexed. Firm up, back firms up, it's easier for legs. If this is slack. your feet that you're using to pull. Of course, keeping your legs straight so that you're strong and negative to pull against. The more you pull your feet, the more your head goes forward because the spine stretches.
Maybe you see if you can bend the ankles. Bend the ankles a little bit. Yeah.
You mean
yeah,
here?
Yeah, not the toes. Not this. Not this, but this.
Okay. Happy birthday.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, he's a birthday boy.
The mini
Yeah.
Okay.
He's doing
okay, this one is bend knees. Yeah, bend knees and hug tight, hug tight.
Okay.
Stomach exercise. This I need to understand a little bit better what would give us more advantage. Of course, the classical way is leg straight, but I wonder if.
What is it?
This way? You tell me.
You will get more massage by more massage in the middle body, or not that much. Just a little bit. Just enough to make the stomach flexible and flex.
Okay.
Yeah, we'll become welcome on the feet on the carpet so that you can slide out as you need to, you know. So as long as my stomach doesn't leave thighs, I'm okay. Right? So I can stretch out as much.
Just sit like this. Put your heel on the carpet.
Birthday boy has a question.
Yes.
Yeah.
Am I supposed to put it in?
That's good.
And
am I supposed to put it in?
Wait.
Not
really.
Not
really. Yeah. Bend knees. Bend knees. And pull. Tight into stomach.
They always need their mom.
Pull. Yeah, there. Tight into stomach. Yeah. Now relax your head. Down. Keep pulling, keep stomach hugging thighs, and then move heels forward, slide heels forward, now away from you. But go with it, go with the thigh. Yeah, don't let the stomach separate from thighs. Okay, and peacock. Raji, let's try and lotus. Hank, if you want to do the belt, use the belt.
Stomach, very good.
So use that strength and then broaden, open the shoulder. Open the shoulders. Roll them back. This is forward. Relax. Open.
You do this to me every time. No, I can't move.
I'm not rolling them.
I'll cheat.
They're more.
Here, try just in the front. Here, just sit. And then roll them forward and back. Forward and back. You feel the movement? Ego, they're forward.
So I want it like this.
Back.
I want it like
forward.
This. Got it. This.
After the pose. That's to get right. In the pose, you need to do this.
Then open up.
But then open up. Right.
Okay.
So this movement, this mm-hmm. movement. And once you have a weight, this.
When you go,
fluid, I think you're going to disconnect.
This leg. Put your head down, lift your leg. That's all.
And does it make
just
it easier?
Just don't try to lift your head up. So just put it down. Slide forward and put the head down.
I gotta get the alignment right.
Put the head down.
Yeah.
Sliding forward.
Yeah.
There
you
go.
Oh,
it
looks
like
that.
Maybe that way.
Yeah.
Yeah, look, slide forward. Legs are forward. Yeah. That's how they fly, you know?
That's
they go to the place and lean.
to fly.
We'll fly one day.
It helps.
Let's try again.
That did help.
Yeah, broaden the shoulders, Mark. Broaden the shoulders. Let me keep toes on the floor. Mark, toes on the floor and broaden the shoulders. Push shoulders back.
Yeah, I'll take a try again. I'll take a picture now. Let's try the wall headstand. With
it's challenging to open them, but it helps you move forward.
Very good.
Okay, now keep toes on the floor and lift your head as well.
I couldn't go. So.
Okay.
Anything for the picture.
Okay. Toes on the floor.
Yeah, toes on the floor. Yeah, don't lift your feet. Yeah, yeah, just lift your head as much as you can. Lift, 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 lift. Lift. It's easier to lift. It's easier to lift.
I figure it should be.
Watch Hank if he's trying to march back. Yeah, so you slow down. I think you'll be able to develop more strength. Yeah, bring arms closer. No, they compare the picture, Mark. Yeah, and see when Hank tries it.
Oh, you want me to take a picture of Hank?
No. Just see if his shoulders come up.
Oh, I see.
Back, back, back.
Okay.
Back,
unless you got written permission.
No.
That was a forceful.
Definitely.
Back.
That's all I need. We found him.
Go for the head first. Do the pickup first and then your head goes down. Do the pickup and then slide forward and then the head shift.
The birds read a book how to fly.
What's that?
Do the birds read a book and learn
how to fly? Oh, my.
So to go to the
back is much more curved.
Yeah, but then within this, right? So I'm not sure why lifting head would be. So you were actually much easy. So you really have gone too much forward because your feet lift up too easily. This.
Okay, let me try that.
This. So do a back thing.
Yeah,
keep feet on the floor. And you know, this is how the peacocks are actually. If you see that their tails are on the floor.
Right.
Or, close to the floor.
Right.
And their heads are up like this. Shift back a little bit. Yeah, shift your weight back a little bit. Yeah. There. I'll broaden the chest. There. Much better.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that is my. Your back was not wrong.
Pushing out other direction, but this is the first.
Yeah.
You can see the shoulder blades pushing out and the sharp angle to head to peak.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
So I think if you keep working on this strength, the back strength, so it's weight and back bend, right? It's weight and it's a back bend.
Right.
Not a forward bend. Forward bend is you're putting your weight on your forearm bones.
Yeah.
This, you're lifting. Pushing against your forearm bones. Pushing against your forearm bones, but you're arching your back.
Yeah, and that's where the
the back muscle needs to engage and strength. Strength will need it.
Next, push back.
Sorry.
What next at 7?
Say that you can't go home. That be peacock or fish?
Fish.
I think She hasn't gotten
lift
the
head
breakup.
Up.
Now,
you put
your head up.
Forward bend. Continue the back bend. Yeah, now back bend. Back bend. Ribs land on your elbows.
Ribs.
Yeah. Back bend. Back bend. Keep taking the wall. And
the back.
Do back bend. Do back bend. Do back bend. Back bend. Yeah. Yeah. Like that. Like that. Like that. And then we'll take your time. And out. And out.
Oh, sorry.
Like that, like that, like that. Sort of.
That's okay. Good.
Can I use one of these?
Sure.
I like the cue in this one, push back when you told us to put your elbows down. To push your elbows down and fish. I hadn't thought about that, but it's better.
Yeah, above, right, right, and open the shoulders better.
Yes, but I did. You said that on. Exactly. But it helps.